Hello guys, and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. Today in this tutorial we will learn what is input function and what is raw input function and what is the difference between the both function and how they will behave in Python 2 and Python 3. Okay, so first we'll start with the Python 2. In Python 2 there are two functions to get the input from the user. Okay, and the first one is raw input function and second one is input function. Okay, so in Python 2 there are two input functions. One is raw input and second one is input function. Both of these functions are used to get the input from the user. If both this function will do the same work, then there should be a difference between these two functions, and today here we are discussing about that. Okay, so first we'll discuss about the raw input in Python 2. This raw input is used to get the input from the user. So it will takes what exactly user typed and passes it back as string. That's nothing but if you enter an integer input also, it will treat that as a string value and it will pass that as a string value. If you enter list also, it will treat that as a string value. It will pass that string value. That's nothing but here if. So in the raw input, it will take whatever the user typed input. Okay. And it will passes this as the string value. If you enter integer value, list, float, whatever it is, it will treat that as string value only. So we'll see the example for that. So here in Python 2, so I'll take n is equal to raw input. Okay. So now I'll enter and now I'll enter an integer value. Okay. So 10. And I'll enter. Now if I check the value of 10, here we can see this is the string value. As I said, raw input will take the input and it will treat that as the string value. Here, even though we enter the integer value, it will treat that as a string value and it will store that in that variable. So if I check type of n, here we can see type is string. So in Python 2, this raw input can be used when you want to enter an string input. Okay. So if you want to enter the string input, then you can directly enter it. For example, here we can see. If I check name, here we can see it will treat that as a string value. So this is about the raw input. Okay. So next we'll talk about the input function in Python 2. So this input function will take input from the user and it will evaluate that input. That's nothing but if you enter the integer value, it will treat that as the integer value. If you enter list, it will treat that as a list. Okay. Here in the input function, if you enter the input as int, it will evaluate that. Okay. And it will treat that as integer value only. So for example, here I'll take input function now. Okay. And now I'll enter integer value. So now if I check n, it will give integer value 10. Okay. If I check type of n now, here you can see it is int. Okay. I'll take another example, that is name input. Here I'll enter Amul. Here we can see the error because here we entered this string without double quotes or single quotes. Okay. So this is not a string now. So here we can see the error. So here in the case you need to write like this input function. Here you need to enter within the double quotes or single quotes. Now if I check name, here we can see. So this is about the input and raw input in Python 2. So here in the raw input, it will take the input and it will treat that as the string value. If you enter any type of input, it will treat that as string only. In the input function, it will evaluate the input, and if you enter the integer value, it will treat that as integer only, right? We can write of row input is equal to input. If you apply this function on the row input, then this is equal to the input function. So in Python 2, if you want raw input to behave like input function, then you need to write like this, eval of raw input, then it will behave same as the input function. So for that, we'll take one example. If I take raw input, okay. Now if I enter 10, it will treat this as the string. Now if you want to use raw input like input function, then you can use eval of raw input. Now if I enter 22, now if I check n value, it will take 22. Okay, so eval of raw input function is equal to the input function in Python 2. Okay, so this is about the input and raw input. So next we'll see how this input function will behave in Python 3. Okay, so in Python 3, there is only one function to take the input from the user, that is input. Here in Python 3, there is no raw input function. Okay, and this input function in Python 3 will behave same like raw input in Python 2. Okay, this input function is similar to the raw input in Python 2. That's nothing but it will take the input and it will treat that as the string value. It will pass that as the string value. So if we take the example, so here I'll take input, okay. So now if I enter 45 and if I check n, here we can see 45 will be treated as string value and it is stored as string value in variable n. So if I check type of n, here we can see that is string. Okay, so this input function will behave same as raw input in Python 2. Okay, so then if I want to enter an integer value, then how to do that? Then for that you can use int function and you can convert the input and you can use, for example, like this, int input, okay, enter, and here we can see, so it will treat that as the integer value because here we are using int function. It will convert this string input to integer input and it will store that integer input in this variable. Or we can use eval function. That's nothing but here we can see we entered a floating point value and it will take that as the floating point value because here we use eval function. It will evaluate the entered input and that floating point value will be stored in this variable n. Okay, so this is about the input function, raw input function, as well as how they will behave in Python 2 and Python 3. Okay, so that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I'll meet you next class. Till then, take care.